So this is Douglas, Olivier, and Julien. And have you ever noticed we are all developers, but we all have different workflows for our development? Yeah?
Yeah.
Do you like maintaining your grunt file and gulp files for many projects over time?
Hell no.
Yeah, I love it. No, we don't love this. So we decided together to settle together. Yeah. And to imagine the perfect development workflow companion to help us ship and maintain projects over time. So today we'd like to introduce you to ngFactory, which is which is an upgradable development workflow based on top of Gulp.js and focused on AngularJS components and application. So ngFactory is based on best practices and cover the whole development lifecycle from development to build, documentation generation, and even publication.
Okay, so where should we start? The main goal is to be more productive and to maintain a high quality workflow that just works over time. So the key for us was really to find new layers of abstraction so that you can better focus on your code and upgrade your workflow in a safer way. So with that in mind, the first actual thing we wanted to do was to reduce the size of your Gulp files, abstracting away what was really not specific to your application. So indeed, Gulp being a very new ecosystem, it does evolve at a very high pace. And modules get deprecated, there is new ones always coming on. So it's really hard and it takes time to just keep up to date. And even if you've started with a good Yeoman generator, time goes by and it's just not up to date. So in the end, you have like dozens of projects that are all using their unique subset of Gulp tasks. And they have all been generated at some point in time, and they've been untweaked after that to fit your needs. So we really wanted to address this issue and to solve this issue with ngFactory. The idea was somehow to provide generic tasks that could be used and required by your Gulp file. But the issue with Gulp tasks is that they are really quite monolithic and it's not really reusable, at least with the current Gulp orchestrator. So we needed way more flexibility and had to find something else. That's why we came up with something called Combined Transform Stream Factories. And since it sounded a bit complicated, we just called them Gulp channels. So here is a quick example of one of these channels. So it's really just a factory that's going to return. It's using Stream Combiner, the non-module. And it's really just return a reusable series of transformed streams. What's really great about it is that you can easily reuse it anywhere in this channel, anywhere in your workflow, whether it's for a component, an application, or your documentation. So finally, having these reusable channels really helped us achieve something that's both dry and easy to maintain. So,
yeah. So what you get? We want to make documentation and publication easy. And actually, documentation documenting a components is almost always the same thing. You need a getting started, an API documentation, and some examples. So we provide a way to have a common design for every component, have some clean README, so you can have it out of the box without doing anything. And what we require for that is actually what you need to make a component. So your source code, ng documented, and package.json. And we're generating a markdown README and an HTML view from that. For the publication, we want to take your build folder out of the master branch. So we really pushing forward orphan branch to do that. And like it's a lot of Git tricks, we want Travis to do it. And at the end, you end up just making a tag and push it to your repo, and Travis will do the all building and deploying himself.
Thank you. So thanks.
Just well.
If you have any ideas to help in this direction, we are really open to suggestions and stuff. And if you want to help us, we'll be at the Royal Hackathon on Friday. So join us.
Thank you. Thanks. Very much.